Welcome back to the couch. I'm on Aurora Television here. Thank you for joining us. It's a great pleasure to have my good friends from the political parties here today. We've got the Assistant Minister for Health, the Federal Member for Hasluck, Ken Wyatt. Thank you very much for coming in.
Good to see you, Fred.
And the Spokesperson for Aged Care Social Services from the Greens, Senator Rachel Siewert. Thank you very much. Give her a round of applause as well, please. Thank you for coming in, guys. And to make sure that we're all sane, I've got a psychiatrist helping us today.
Psychologist. Thank you. Not a psychiatrist.
Psychologist. But anyway, you're on the couch.
I am on the couch.
And I'll leave you with Nesha and I'll just interject when something nice comes up. Over to you, Nesha.
Thank you very much, Fred. Well, I think we've had a few jokes about me being a psychologist. Hopefully we'll leave that alone for the rest of the segment. So, Ken and Rachel, welcome to the couch. Really being the Christmas show, we're going to talk a little bit about the year that's been and the year that's to come in 2016. So I guess the first question, and I'll point it towards you, Ken, is 2015, what a year. There's been a lot of changes. So what are some of the key changes in 2015, particularly from the Liberal Party's point of view?
Well, the first one is the change of leadership. Mm. Change of leadership in any party is always harrowing. There is old policies and new, and that transition to a new leader who brings their own personality, their own approach, but also in building the confidence of the team is always one of the elements that goes with that. Mm. And I think Malcolm's been tremendous, not only for the party, but also for Australia. So we're off to a good start. 2016, I would expect us to build on the policies, particularly around innovation, taking Australia into the 21st century, some of the key health reforms that Minister Lee is doing. Mm-hmm. So there's a whole raft of exciting elements to policy development. And I'd like to acknowledge the Greens here, even in the last session. Mm-hmm. Their support on a couple of key reforms was well welcomed, and it was great that we had their support for that. I'm remaining optimistic, and I'm looking forward to the new year. I think it'll be great.
Fantastic. It's wonderful to hear that the dynamic really changes when, you know, members change and leadership changes. Do you think that that's obviously going to be quite integral in terms of, I guess, moving issues forward quicker for next year?
I think a change often brings about a dynamic relationship between ministers and backbenchers, but within a party. And the relationship you have with your agencies also plays a critical role in the way that we move forward on many fronts. And often when you stagnate or you appear to be stagnating, the public pick that up and consumer confidence, community confidence wanes. But in Malcolm transitioning to the Prime Ministership, what I see out in the electorate is absolute confidence. Even in the shops today, when I was going through some of the large centres, the number of people there who are now spending and who have some degree of comfort that the future augurs well for them. So I think some families will be having a great Christmas, which is tremendous to see.
But that's wonderful. And you did already mention Rachel and the work of the Greens as well in backing up some of those important decisions this year. Rachel, you've had some leadership changes as well, and do you concur with Ken in terms of the dynamic change in the Greens?
We've certainly had a change of leadership. It was, I think, probably less dramatic than the coalitions. And of course, Richard's brought a new personality, a new approach to it. And I think we've seen, we don't change our policies. I think we've had a different way of messaging those policies. But it's really clear in the parliament that there's sort of been this relax with Turnbull coming in and Abbott, the change. There's just sort of, people have breathed a sigh of relief. It's not so acrimonious. It may not look like it from the outside, but there's even a little bit less angst between the members in the Senate.
Okay,
I don't know what it's like in the House of Reps, but it's certainly like that in the Senate. Mm. And so I think that's allowed people to sort of get on with the job a bit better, to focus on the real issues. Mm. One of the things for us is that I think, and although Malcolm Turnbull's got some policy changes there on the deck, where he does need to be looking at is a social safety net. There's still Abbott baggage there with some of the key policies, and I think that's a real mistake for Mr. Turnbull. I think he's got to re-look at that. Don't look at social services to make cuts. to make savings because they're only short-term savings because they have long-term negative effects. And so it'll be really interesting in 2016 whether he ditches those policies and comes back with policies that are actually fairer.
And let's talk about, I guess, how those policies get looked at and, I guess, the lateral view of that situation with the tax changes in tax. Ken, what's your view? Do you feel like there's a similar view to Rachel, or are there some other areas as well that you feel are critical?
Just on that, I think there are a couple of real salient points. One is the level of borrowing that we've seen in the last 6 years has been astronomical. So we do have to make some reforms that reduces spending. We also have to look at what programs there are that we're able to afford and provide. And I take the point that Rachel raises about safety nets. Now, all governments, and the former Howard government in particular, put into place a series of safety nets to make sure that people didn't fall through them. But there are also areas where, if we look at people who can afford to pay their way, then we should ask them to do that. Yeah. And so it doesn't negate where we have to give consideration to those who do struggle. And Scott Morrison, in an answer he gave in the chamber, gave a clear undertaking that he would be looking at fairness, and in the decisions that would prevail in the changes, then that would also be a factor that he would consider. So, yeah, we have some challenges.
There's still some of those policies have come straight back in again. So, you know, the family tax benefit changes, for example, where we don't agree with the one that the Labor supported the government through. They took the other ones off the agenda, got the one that hurts potentially, well, it will hurt low-income families. And yet the government came straight back with those other changes that will hurt single parents, that will hurt other carers. They paid a little bit of attention to grandparent carers, but they're actually the minority in terms of numbers of carers. And so, yes, they said they'll be fair, but then they brought back the same amendments they wanted to make. Instead of looking at... We would look at some sensible changes to family tax benefit. It is one of the areas that Howard brought in that we criticised at the time for being overly generous. So it is appropriate to look at it, but the changes they're making we don't think are fair. So let's look at what's fairer. They've brought back in the policy and the bill that says to young people you have to stay off income support for 5 weeks, saying it's from New Zealand when in fact it's not true. They don't do that in New Zealand. And so, you know, those sorts of things, on one hand they're saying, yes, it's fair. On the other hand, bringing in the same policies that Mr Abbott had, essentially.
Sorry to interrupt. I was just going to say, Malcolm Turnbull's been saying a lot of, it's a great time to be an Australian. Do you see that maybe being the focus that we need to... Because I actually like what he's saying about that. It's about people being less negative next year. Maybe starting now into next year, we need to be... The country's a wonderful country. We're a safe country. We're a positive country. People can live... We're taking in Syrians, refugees. Finally, we're doing something that's humanitarian. We're a wonderful place. And I love the fact the Prime Minister, Ken, is saying it's a great time to be an Australian. Do the Greens agree with that, that we need to be optimistic and maybe next year move into a more positive... maybe a more positive politics arena rather than stick... I know what you're saying, Rachel, but the same old policies that are nasty are coming out. I think there will be a change. Can you make Rachel happy? Because she'd like to see a more sensitive government.
Yeah, I think that's what Rachel...
Yeah, let's make some policy announcements now.
Do you think that... Like the GST, everyone's talking about the 15% GST. It's always seen as a disaster. I'd like to say the GST, most Australians will say it's a great idea. I would rather you put it up.
Just on the GST, that is a debate that was brought into the arena by the state premiers. And so all of the discussions around tax reform will encompass a whole range of taxes, what the states charge, and whether there's a need to look at a better arrangement within the Federation. Because we have to remember that the states raise their own revenue, and at one point they handed them over to the Commonwealth in that early part of the century, and they never ever got them back. So the Commonwealth has been the principal fundraiser. In terms of making Rachel happy, there are certain things that we will agree on, but there are others that we won't, because the Greens supported the changes to single pension parents. And the cut.
No, we didn't.
I didn't hear you howling a protest.
Can I ask a question,
to
Rachel?
To payments to single parents, you mean?
Yeah.
We were the only ones that objected to that, repeatedly.
No, we objected as well.
to changes. We did not support that. Go back and check the Hansard record.
Rachel,
I'm
well
on the record
about single
parents.
I know you are.
You know what? Can I just say, you two are wonderful because you're the human side of politics. You do get on very well. You have a lot of similarities. Things that bring you together, to take a John Howard phrase, the things that bring you together are greater than things that divide you. Do you think, honestly, Rachel, the Greens would love to see Malcolm Turnbull there as Prime Minister, are they starting to like the Liberal government with Malcolm Turnbull, or do you prefer Bill Shorten?
We're not going to say one over the other.
Just
at the
case
moment.
One with.
We strongly oppose quite a lot of the policies that the ALP want to do.
Correct.
So, you know, the changes to single parents, for example, which they've now changed their minds about, but they're the ones that made the second law changes to single parents. They refused to support the tax avoidance measures that we actually amended the government's bill, because that bill, actually, people supported the bill. We had a series of amendments on tax avoidance. We didn't achieve everything we wanted, but we made good progress. And that's, so at the end of last session, we had, what was it? I think I was in the chamber for nearly 10 hours straight on that bill. And so that's something that we supported with the government because they agreed to our changes.
We're right out of time. Just a quick one. Next year, what do we think we're focusing on? What's the main topic next year?
Election.
And what about driving and using a mobile phone? Has that been a topic at all this year? Have you guys... What do you guys think of that? Honestly,
Fred,
on a joking side.
I won't use a mobile phone while I'm driving. You are distracted.
What about
from the safety
coffee
of others
while you're driving?
No, not even that either. No.
You shouldn't. Yeah, you've got to... It's really clear that if you're distracted when you're driving, that you can have serious consequences.
And what about this wonderful photo, Ken? I thought I'd get him back for you, Rachel. This is Ken, actually, and this is Anna, his lovely wife. Now, Ken, tell us why this is hanging up here at our side studio.
It was a photo taken about 15 years ago, and we'd won an award, or Anna had won an award for a program on otitis media. And so they wanted a photograph to hang here, and I thought that they had all disappeared.
That you look pretty hot there, Ken, can I say? And Anna, you don't scrub up too badly either. You guys are wonderful politicians. Are you doing anything over Christmas? But I know we've just about sent Jake Dennis home, but that's okay. He can't sing now. He's run out of time. But what are you guys doing over Christmas? What's the good side of Christmas? Is it spending it with your families and friends?
Family time, and then spending a couple of days down south.
Beautiful. And then back into it again?
Family time and down at Bunbury and probably Busselton and then back into the Hartslog.
And is it a great time to be an Australian?
Yes,
and to be in Australia.
It's always a great time
to be
in
Australia.
And that
never
one
changes.
We always agree on. Thank you very much. Thank you to Nesha. Sorry for cutting you off there, but you're happy.
No
anyway.
Problems. Nice to have a good chat.
That is our Pollie Waffle for this year. Thank you to Ken White. Thank you to Rachel Siewert. We hope to see them back next year. They are great politicians. They're always in for a chat here locally. And they're doing big things. They're actually the nice people of politics. They say it the way it is. Next year, more Pollie Waffle. We're going to take a break, because we ran over time with that. Jake, hang around the green room. We'll be to you in a moment. And we'll be back with more of The Couch right after this. We're talking to Tim Gossage and Maddie from 6IX.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas and a happy...
Everybody dance now!
One, two, three, four!
Everybody dance now!
Yeah, everybody over here, everybody over there. The crowd is live and I'm cool with...
Welcome back to The Couch on Foxtel, and a Merry Christmas to you. And only a week to go before Christmas. Hope you're enjoying our two-hour special. It always gives me great pleasure here in WA to promote other people who are doing a great job on Perth Radio. And today we're introducing a new team. They are, of course, Goss and Maddie on Breakfast on 1080 6AX Forever Classic. Give them a round of applause. Welcome. And I've got to say, I've known Tim for many years working at 6PR and also Channel 10. But Maddie, we worked together years ago at Access 31, which we don't want to remember too much about. But we've all been around Perth a long time. So it's really nice when you get Perth people doing local radio. Mm. Yeah. And it's so nice that 6IX have decided to go with local. And I think you're going to be a winner. So welcome to Morning Radio.
Thank
both
you.
To you. Are you both excited? Maybe Tim? Oh,
yeah, absolutely. I think more so that it's, without wanting to be too cliched, Fred, it's going to be new. Mm. And it's a combination. You've got, you know, your AM station and your FM station and with our selection of music and, you know, over an hour, 5 or 6 songs an hour, plus what's happening then and there. Not just sport, because I'm a sports head, not just news with Maddie, but we're trying to really include Perth. And I think, look, that happens across all the radio demographics. We're just going to be, I think it's going to be a point of difference with what we do. We're pretty excited. We're not reinventing the wheel, but we're going to be fresh.
Well, you're both likeable people. I mean, obviously with the news and you with Channel 10 News, people know you and people like you, and newsreaders are sometimes the best people for people to recognise. Mm. And doing breakfast, it's going to be different. But I can see the blend already, and that's really important to have a blend between the two of you. It's like you're an on-air team, aren't you? And you're on-air marriage, in a sense, isn't it?
It is. It's a new
Can
marriage.
We not talk marriage again, Fred? It hasn't been good to me. No, it's all been all good. I'm looking
Maddie, what
to
do you
it.
Think?
Well, I think we're in the honeymoon phase right now.
Has he taken you somewhere expensive?
No.
No, I'm looking for it. Maddie's actually in charge.
Yeah.
Maddie's panelling. Maddie's the first voice. Maddie's going to be the voice of the show.
Do you know what? That's going to be amazing.
It's really new for us. And for me, coming from, you know, I've been at Nova the past 5 years, doing a breakfast show, writing and reading news every morning. So to come and do this, it's completely different. I've come from an excellent team and I've learned so much in the past half a decade that I've been with Nova. And coming to 6IX, I actually worked at 6IX over 10 years ago. So to come back for a station of to a station I've always had a soft spot for, with Leo Nelson and Gordon O'Byrne and a new team. We're all on the same page as
to
well.
To come
it's
back
all about
anywhere
Perth,
is pretty good.
Relatable.
It is.
Yeah.
Isn't it?
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. Can I ask a 6IX, for those people who haven't listened to the fantastic Forever classic music, tell us a little bit about 6IX. What can we expect to hear in the morning? What sort of type of music? And what are your ingredients for your breakfast show? What are you looking? I know it's all new, so you're going to be changing it around. But why should people listen to you guys? And how are you going to be different to Steve and Baz on our team at 6PR? How's it going to be different from the other shows? And I'm sure it's
the music's a big thing, and that's not going to change. And also, I think with what we're going to try and do is, a word that we spoke about when we first met to talk about how we're going to be a team was now. Mm. And it's going to be Perth. We don't actually care about, no disrespect, reality stars on the East Coast. We want to be Perth, things that are happening in your suburbs. We want to include people. And you know, there will be a minimal talk back, but there will be interaction with the audience. We're not giving away trips to Melbourne Cups and trips to grand finals. And we would be lucky to give away $10 a day.
That's all right.
But what we will do is people just have fun doing it. And we want to have fun. And we don't want to be offensive. Mm. We don't want to be too heavy duty. We want light and bright.
Do you think that's what's lacking in Perth? Because I tend to agree with you. I think we've got to go back to basics and talk about everyday things. Family, fun, lifestyle, and not so much politics if we can avoid it.
Yep.
But I think that your music is going to be fantastic because you do play 50s, 60s, 70s and 80s.
Yep. Do you remember those years?
Of course I do.
Do you? Do you remember the 70s and 80s, Maddie?
Yeah, I love Jukebox Saturday Night. Yes. We're still doing that. I used to co-host that with Roland
What's your
Green
favourite
10
song?
Years ago. Uptown Girl, Billy Joel.
I always say ABBA because I'm always covered if I say ABBA. Tim, go ahead.
It's just going to be a really fun show, as Goss said, all about Perth. We're having a news background, really reactive as well. If there's something happening, you know, an event or something that's happening or breaking news, we'll have it on our show straight away. Going to be fun and relatable. No stunts.
No, and the only rumours you'll hear on our show, Fred,
are the ones you create. Fleetwood Mac.
There you go, Fred.
Can I
throw that in there? I don't know if you saw the link there, Fred, but
well, yeah, I have, but I thought I'd ignore it. But that's okay. Can I just do a little? I know we're running out of time. I've been given the wind up. 5 minutes goes so quick. You're going to start what date in Perth Radio? What day are we going to? Well, I know, listen in every day. Don't just switch on in January. Listen now. I've been given a tip. There might be something happening. But when do you officially start on air?
11th of January.
At what time?
We hit the deck,
5:30 to 9, Monday to Friday.
And that's on 1080 AM 6IX and also 1057 FM in the north and the south.
Yep, that's
and
right.
And on beautiful digital radio like I do, it sounds better than 96 FM. The music's a hell of a lot better. I'm being honest, and I think it is fantastic. I love your style of music. I love your show. I think you're going to be fantastic. Can I give you a little bit of an introduction before we go to Jake Dennis, who's going to sing for us? I'm going to pretend to be the voiceover man. Can you open the show, your first breakfast show for me? From the top of the Banquest Tower and IKEA's Food Bowl. It's 1080 AM 6IX with Goss and Maddie.
Good morning. It's 7:05.
It's going to be 27 degrees today and we're looking forward. If you're listening in Subiaco or Balladura, thanks very much. 1080 6IX, Goss and Maddie with you.
They did that, so we'll give them a round of applause. They are good for 25 years in television, 25 years as his partner on radio. I think it's going to be
a long 25 years.
Enjoy the time together. And
Maddie's going to be the boss. You've heard it first here on the couch. Thank you very much. Congratulations. All the best for your new show. We're going to be listening in. And don't forget, you can listen online as well sometimes. If you are... Actually, no, you can't, because they're on digital radio now. I think I tried online. Yep. But 6OX is the station. Listen in now. Try the change. And we'll see them there as well. Thank you very much.
Thanks.
One guy you probably won't have on your show is Jake Dennis. He's a wonderful singer, and he's going to perform for us now because he's got a Christmas song. Here's Jake, centre stage.
Down. He's making a list, checking it twice. He's gonna find out who's naughty and nice. Santa Claus is coming to town. He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows when you're awake. He knows if you've been bad or good. So be good for goodness sake. You better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town.
Ladies and gentlemen, I just want to say Merry Christmas to everyone, and I hope that you have all your Christmas dreams come true. You're listening to the sounds of Jake Dennis and the Minch Jazz Band, Mark Cunningham from piano, Kate Pass on double bass, and Chris Marcan on drums.
He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows when you're awake. He knows if you've been bad or good. So be good, for goodness sake. You better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming. Santa Claus is coming. Santa, he's coming to town.
Jake Dennis, thank you very much, and always glad to have Jake. And don't forget the Mint Jazz Band as well that is performing all around Perth over Christmas, New Year. Now, a very special treat. We've got Nick the Noise and, of course, Frankie Rooster doing a fantastic piece of music called...
Santa Claus Blues. Can I put this one out together?
Wonderful. Don't forget to catch them. They're performing all around Perth. You can book them. They're wonderful people. Over to you guys.
Thank you, Fred. Isn't that nice? What a nice introduction.
Lovely.
Fred over there, right?
Yes.
Hey, Nick.
Yes.
Now, here we are on the couch again, mate.
Frank, it feels good.
It feels really good, Nick. Now, we're going to do this song called The Santa Claus Blues, which we've written specifically for this show.
Yes.
And, Nick, I want to know, do you have your U-Butte pretend blues harp ready to go? So I need to know that. Oh, that's good. It's all there. Now, can you tell me, just before we start here, Nick, can you tell me what key is that blues harp in?
Pretend C.
Pretend C. Perfect. OK, that's good. So let's do this. All right, you ready to go?
I'm ready to go.
All right, here we go. Let's get this sleigh in the sky. We got a bag full of goodies for this Christmas night ride. So giddy up the Rudolph, we gotta get to Jabberoo. there's a little boy waiting to play his new didgeridoo. Oh, well, he blow a little tune in the middle of the room with his family all around them. He grew the tune to sound, hey, yeah. Make the noise, ladies and gentlemen, on PVC didgeridoo right here. Oh, well, giddy up the Rudolph, we got to get to Mount Pike. Oh, well, giddy up the Rudolph, we got to get to Mount Pike. Well, there's a little girl
What?
Mount Pike?
Mount Pike.
Where's Mount Pike?
You don't know where Mount Pike is.
I don't know where Mount Pike
you
is.
You don't know where Mount Pike is.
I've never seen Mount Pike. I don't know anybody from Mount Pike.
You've never seen, you don't know anything.
I don't know where Mount Pike is.
Well, that makes two of us. All I know is it's in the McDonald Ranges and it rhymes with bike, which is great for our next verse.
Beautiful. Yeah.
There we go.
All right.
Well, giddy up the Rudolph. Oh, Mount Pike.
Going to find Mount Pike.
Now come on, Nick, that's an old one. He's been around for hundreds of years. You can do that. GPS, mate, modern game. Come on. Well, giddy up the Rudolph, we gotta get to Mount Pike.
Mount Pike.
Well, giddy up the Rudolph, we gotta get to Mount Pike.
Mount Pike.
Oh, there's a little girl waiting to ride a new mountain bike. Riding gear on, she'll be riding down the track. She'll be on a bike and gone. Well, giddy up the Rudolph, giddy up the Rudolph, giddy up the Rudolph. She had a bit of trouble there, didn't she? Oh well, hey there, Nicky. Frankie's got an itchy nose. I said, hey there, Nicky. Frankie's got an itchy nose. I need you to scratch it, cause I'm playing this here piano. It's kind of threw me out a little bit there. Well, there's an itch that comes and goes from my head down to my toes. Dishing for a while and it's bound to grab my star. Yeah, giddy up there, Rudolph.
Alrighty then.
Hey, giddy up there, Rudolph.
Yeehaw.
We got a lot of little places in this big wide land. We gotta go.
Gotta go.
Last verse, Nick. You ready? You're gonna help me out, right? Well, giddy up there, Rudolph. There's no snow in Australia. Giddy up there, Rudolph. There's no snow in Australia. Apparently, lots of confetti. They got sunshine there for Christmas. Yo-ho-ho and yo-ho-ho. They got sunshine there for Christmas. Yo-ho-ho and yo-ho-ho. One more time, Nick, we'll do it right this time. One sunshine there for Christmas. Aussie, Aussie, yo-ho-ho. We'll do that one more time, one more time. They got sunshine there for Christmas. Aussie, Aussie, yo-ho-ho. Thank you very much. Merry Christmas. I'm Frankie Rooster.
Nick the Noise.
And we'd like to throw right back to Fred there. Freddie, back to Freddie over there. Well, what have you done to my piano? What's the matter with you? You're up here.
Yo! Aussie, Aussie, Aussie. Ho, ho, ho.
Well done.
Thank you very much to Nick the Noise and Frankie Rooster, and thanks for being part of our Christmas show. It is always nice having a bit of entertainment, light entertainment. Someone that's all about entertainment is my next guest. I love talking to her. She's been a legend on television and radio for a very long time. Let me introduce her by saying this and showing you this on air. Susie Ellerman, here she is. Susie. Welcome, Susie.
Thank you, Fred.
It's been
May I say legend is probably a little strong to use for me. I don't think I've earned the legend.
Oh.
But thank you for the elevation.
You're pretty bloody good, I'd say.
Well, I guess if it means I've survived over 40 years in the business, I suppose that's pretty legendary.
You know, Susie, I've never known how you got into... tell us how you got into the entertainment, radio, TV stuff.
Well, I didn't come through the normal channels, so I don't have a degree. I didn't go to university. I actually was enrolled in Teachers College, and a lovely lady came up to me at my Year 12 formal and asked me to go into the Miss Australia quest.
Mm-hmm.
Long story short, I did. That changed my life, and then I got into media that way.
Sounds
because
funny.
Because as a title holder, yep. You actually travel around, and I appeared on a lot of TV channels, and Wynn Television rang me up and said, would you like to come down and audition for a show?
And that's how it all happened. That was a start. Very similar to my starting in television, of course. I'm not Miss Australia, of course, but I did, though I would have been able to do that if they asked me to. But Susie, you're one of these people that's amazing. What did you start with? Did you start with radio or TV or news presenting? What was your first thing at Wynn?
No, I actually started on television. So Wynn Television was my first job.
Okay.
I went down to co-host a morning women's program, and when I got down there, the show had folded.
Really?
So yes, and they said, well, don't worry, we'll find you stuff to do. And they certainly did for the next 13 years. And then I was coached by Channel 7, and then I got glandular fever and blah, blah, blah. Then went to Channel 7 and, oh, gosh, you know, yeah. You just go back and forth with all the channels and careers and shows.
Amazing, because, you know, talking about your show folding up, I actually did an interview with The Catch-Up on Channel 9 a few years ago. The day after I did the interview with them, we flew over to Sydney, did this interview, and then they folded. The next day they got axed. Do you think television is what it used to be? Because we don't seem to give things a go anymore, do we?
Well, it's all based on this magical number that if the ratings don't get over a million, the show's not a success. I think free-to-air television is just filled these days of reality television, and it gets repeated now. Good it evening. Used to be repeated, not fashionable, to have encore
yes.
of each show. So we get that infinitum. Look, I think it's really difficult now that you can binge-watch these shows without commercial breaks through various other avenues. So, yes, exactly. So it's a completely different playing field now than when I first started in television. And I think everybody just has to go with the flow and work out what their niche is.
Now, I know you're pretty hands-on. You're one of these people like myself that you like to be involved in every part of the production so you know what people do, and it's a great idea. I do it as well here in Perth. Your show, Susie, what happened to that? Because that was an amazing show. We watched it here in Perth on Channel 9 when it was part of Wynn. What happened to Susie?
It was an absolute honour to go back and work for Wynn Television, because when I left them, they were one station. When I came back, they were geographically the largest network in Australia. So it was an honour to be able to make it. We made that show on a shoestring, and, you know, it would take me far longer than what we've got time on television to tell you all the things that led up to it. Suffice to say that the owner of the network was really furious that it was cancelled.
Amazing. That's Bruce Gordon, of course. Local television's amazing. Like, we don't have a lot of local television anymore. I get annoyed because there's so much American stuff and English stuff and foreign stuff on television now. Even with all the multi-channels, it's mainly filled up with all the stuff that's on Foxtel that's not Australian. Does that annoy you sometimes when you have a look?
Well, Fred, I've had a lot to do with submissions for the renewal of your licence, etc. And we're very lucky that there are guidelines set down for Australian content. Otherwise, I don't think we'd have an industry at all.
Exactly. Would you like to go back to TV? Because I know I'm going to touch on your new career in radio, which isn't that new. But would you like to do TV again? If you did TV again, what would you love to do? What would be the ideal job for Susie Elliman?
Well, I'm actually currently still on television. When I came back to Sydney, after I left Wynn in 2010, I came back to Sydney. And for the last 6 years, I've been a regular on the morning show at Channel 7 with Larry and Kylie.
Oh, well, that was why I saw that online. Now, what days do you do that?
Oh, it varies.
Oh, okay.
It just depends, you know, sort of depending on the flow of the show, et cetera. At the moment, it's Thursdays, but it was Mondays, spring Fridays. It just depends.
Susie, you're on the same network I work for, Macquarie Radio Network or Media.
Yes.
You do 2GB Radio, which is the number one talkback station in Australia. How great is that?
Look, it's again, a privilege and an honour to be able to do it, because I know how many people would love to get into radio. My show now goes to 4BC in Brisbane as well as 2GB, mm-hmm. and it's been awesome. I actually panel myself, so yes. I do absolutely everything. I mean, I've got a producer that vets all the calls, yep. but other than that, I do absolutely everything. So it's you can teach an old dog new tricks.
We're in good company then, because I do the same on overnights. Now, it's called Overnight, isn't it, with Susie Ellerman?
Are you it is.
Midnight to
and
6?
And I'm sorry. Well, yes. Well, I'm doing, over summer, I'm doing both Saturday morning and Sunday morning, mm-hmm. midnight till 6. And people can actually listen live via 2gb.com, their website. You can listen live off the homepage.
And what is the phone call number? What's the talkback number over there?
131-873.
And people can talk to you on a Friday night and Saturday night, which is Saturday morning, Sunday morning.
That's the one.
Are you enjoying the radio thing? Because I know I do overnights as well here at 6PR on the same network, and it can be quite tiring. You get a lot of listeners and a lot of people that we need to talk to. Do you find it different to when you were on TV?
It's a whole different skill set, but it is fantastic. It is the original social media.
Fantastic.
You are immediate. It is exhilarating. It's probably one of the most challenging things I've ever done in media. Because, as you know, you've only got the person's first name, yep. and a couple of words about what they want to talk about, and the rest is like flying by the seat of your pants.
And anything can happen on live radio as well. Susie, just quickly, I'd love to touch that you're an ambassador for so many charities. Are you still involved in the same amount of charities as you used to be?
Oh, yes, yeah, very much so. It's one of those things where I learnt very early in my life, Fred, that because my parents and my eldest brother are refugees. They came to Australia in 1950 with £5 in their pocket. Mm-hmm. My dad was a Holocaust survivor.
Wow.
So we always learnt to give back to the country that gave us the start.
Fantastic.
That changed our lives. And this Christmas Day, actually, I'm doing the 5-hour live outside broadcast at the Exodus Foundation,
yep.
for the Reverend Bill Cruz in Uniting Church, where he and his team will feed about 2,000 homeless.
Fantastic. We've got a similar thing here called Mission Australia, Lunch in the Park. It's a wonderful cause, isn't it?
It is sensational, because it's not only just for homeless people, but if anyone's on their own over Christmas,
correct.
And let's face it, that's the most vulnerable time. So just to get out and see people and have a lovely meal that you haven't cooked yourself, it's great.
No, look, fantastic. What's the other charity you're doing work with?
Oh, my goodness.
There's about 50 of them.
How long have you got? Actually, I've just been asked to be an ambassador for Waste Not, Want Not, and it is an incredible initiative that we probably don't have time to talk too much about now, but it's the farmers in the Riverina, instead of ploughing their excess produce underground again or feeding it to the animals,
yeah.
they give it to Waste Not, Want Not,
and
who distribute it through Food Bank to all the people in need.
Do you know what? I'm going to call you again in the new year, and we'll touch on some of these charities, because they do some amazing work. We've got Food Bank WA that does similar work over here, and they do some amazing work, the charities. They do more than government these days. I'm also an
exactly.
ambassador. It's nice to be part of organisations like that, and I'm sure you're very privileged to be part of it, and you're probably very honoured.
Food Bank now, as you say, is Australia-wide.
Yes.
And for the first time, they've got fresh fruit and veggies. Thanks to Waste Not, Want Not.
Susie, what are you doing for Christmas on a personal note?
Oh, well, as I said, I'll be doing the live outside broadcast from 9
Christmas
to 2.
Day.
Then I've got a front back up that night to do midnight till dawn, and then front up again the following day to do midnight to dawn again. So it'll be the inside the 2GB.
Do you know what? We should get married, because that's my life as well. Can I just... I'll do the tag for you, because this is what I hear every week when I'm on there. Keeping you company overnight. Susie Ellerman. Do you have that tag?
I tell you what, you best send that to me.
I know.
In a WAVE file, because I'll be paying.
Do you know the way Macquarie works? It's probably the cheapest way we can do it as well. But that's all good. Thank you very much for spending some time with us. Have a wonderful Christmas. It is wonderful to finally catch up and talk to you face to phone. And it's incredibly nice. If you're ever in Perth, we'd love to have you here and maybe come on the show live. But keep up the great work. Keep up your work with being ambassador to so many charities. What's your website, Susie?
Just myname.com, SusieEllman.com. It's got lots of E's and lots of L's, so good luck.
Thank you very much, and you're doing a great job on 2GB, and thanks for being part of our Christmas show. Merry Christmas.
Oh, you're a treasure, and if I get to Perth, I'll be beating your door down.
Do it. I'd love to be walking around Perth showing you the sights. Well done, Susie.
Thanks, Fred. Bye.
Bye-bye, Susie. That is Susie Ellerman, of course. She's a wonderful talent, a great legend in Australian and radio, television and all that sort of thing. And she's just a bloody nice person. Merry Christmas to her. We'll see you after the break with our final, very special segment. Thanks to Kmart, we're doing Christmas gifts. Stay tuned. Welcome back to the couch here on our Christmas special. Thanks for watching and thanks for joining us on Foxtel as well. With me now is a very young lady called Lauren Nettle. Hello, Lauren.
Hi, Fred. How are you?
I'm doing really well. Now, today you've been doing all our makeup.
Yes, I have.
Now, is it hard to do makeup on people?
I mean, you've got to have some people skills, but it's not overly hard.
I thought you were going to say you've got to have some people.
Well, that too, you do have to have some people. And that helps.
Are you an expert in all types of makeup?
I do photography, I do weddings, TV, obviously, now.
Can you do that gruesome type of stuff, you know, like vampires and all that costume
I don't types? Do a lot of that. I tend to stick to the event and weddings.
So you just did mine quite naturally today?
Yeah, just a little bit of a flush.
Now, you do weddings and engagements and that type of makeup as well?
Yep, and lots of photography.
Photography as well. So if people want to get a hold of you, what's the best way?
The best way is probably either on Facebook, it's Lauren Nettle Makeup Artist, or on my website, which is laurennettlemakeupartist.com.au.
Well done. And do you want to give out your phone number as well, or you don't want to give that out?
That's 0423 169 089.
Charlton, one of our presenters, has now written that down. He'll be calling you up. He said to me something about he wanted to make up with you, and I said, I don't think you got it right. Anyway, thank you very much, Lauren. Give us the name again, Lauren Nettle.
That's Lauren Nettle Makeup Artist.
And the website again?
Is laurennettlemakeupartist.com.au.
And get in there and support her. Thank you very much.
Great.
You
thank
can
you,
escape
Fred.
Now. Well done. Guess what, folks? It's time to introduce my co-host for this segment, thanks to Kmart, Natalie Foster.
Hey, Fred.
Come on over, Nat.
Thank you.
Now, thanks to Kmart, we're giving away some amazing gifts at the end of this. But I've asked you to have a look at these gifts and tell me your best. There's 35 of them that Kmart has given us, folks.
Right.
35, but we can only look at about 15.
Yeah. So do you know, yesterday I did all my Christmas shopping in one afternoon at Kmart.
Did you?
Can I tell you something too? This is Mogwai, and Mogwai is my little dog. And the little reindeer outfit, Kmart, thank you very
much. How good is that? That Kmart has everything now, folks.
I know.
You've got no reason to shop at Big W. Let them go bankrupt. Go to Kmart. They're going bankrupt anyway, so who cares?
Oh,
let's go.
Awkward.
No, not really. You're quite honest. Let's have a look. Let's start with your gifts. We've got some of our crew behind here that are going to be our models.
We have. I put Mogwai down.
Oh, I hope I don't step on you.
No, she'll probably just piss on the floor somewhere.
Oh, that's lovely.
So, big this year, anything to do with Star Wars. So, if you want to hold up Darth Vader there.
Darth Vader.
He is one of the it toys this year if you've got kids. It's brilliant. I know I love
bucks.
Men in Black. Is that how much
was? $39.
That's really good. But if that's a little bit too expensive, you've got things that you can clean your teeth with if you really want to clean your teeth. I don't bother. I just eat mints. Star Wars caps. This is actually good for an adult too because you've got a little stubby holder there.
Do you know what I love about the Darth Vader? It does nothing. It does nothing at all.
Do you know what? I was pressing all his buttons thinking he'd start vibrating.
Nothing at all.
And then it would have been even more interesting.
and I was amazed. It does nothing.
And look at his hand. I mean, that's not going to give you a good time, is it?
But no.
No, I was a little disappointed that he did nothing. I thought he was either going to go, I'm your father or something, but nothing like that. Okay, summer, hot. What you need is a swimming pool. Step one. Step two, get yourself an inflatable swan.
And water.
Oh, yeah, fill it up. Yep. Swan or flamingo? I just saw the word inflatable.
These, can
and
I tell you,
excited.
They sold out. On the day I went to Kmart and got these guys, they sold out. You can get them at Red Dot at 5 times the price,
yep.
But $29, what a bargain.
Well, I've got the swan. Now, my brother bought that in Sydney last year. It cost him an arm and a leg. Kmart have got them now. I have to go and get a flamingo. So you've got a matching pair.
$29.
See what their babies look like. $29, really good.
This is awesome.
Christmas
to hold
colour.
It for you.
Do you know what? This is the thing everyone's getting into at the moment is colouring in.
Adult stuff,
too. I'm trying to understand it myself as well. So I like to colour in after a couple of Baileys, but then I go outside the squares, which is shocking.
They're really good value. And there's also, can I tell you, some great cookbooks and stuff. It came up for around $10, folks, $10 or $12.
The cookbooks are great. We've got seafood, we've got barbecue. I love a bit of barbecue.
And that one there, did you have a look at that one?
Oh, anything to do with Matt Preston, he could poo on a piece of paper and I'd buy it because I love Matt Preston, seriously. I didn't even have a look at it. Maybe not a poo, but, you know, along those lines, it's a beautiful book.
It's an awesome book. It's got great pictures.
I didn't even look at it. I just bought it yesterday. So, and I also just bought this as well, because number one, Family Feud. My brother's just come back from Sydney.
Oh, there you go.
So all the family's in Perth now. And number two, I think my mum's got a crush on the little fella right there. So that's a good one. Dancing speakers. We've got lots of stuff here.
Oh, yes, this one here.
Music. You know, music is fantastic.
This one's the coloured one, isn't it?
Yeah, I like that. So you can hook that up to your iPhone, take to the beach and annoy the shit out of everyone around you.
$10 at the fair.
Picnic, if you want to annoy more people.
Oh, I'm going to keep this one because I love this. This one here, you just plug your iPod into it.
Yes, I know.
And you can just sit on the grass.
Well, you can do that with this one too.
That one as well.
That one's louder.
Okay.
And then this one, again, after you've been drinking at Christmas time, they're a lot more fun. You plug them in and then the water bubbles.
It's like that music thing that you see in different cities.
Yeah. So by the first week in January, you're going to be over there. This is great if you can't be bothered and can't think of things to buy for people. Buy them these little
baskets.
They're
around $20, Nat.
Great idea. This I love because...
I'll hold that
Do you watch Pickers? I love that show, Pickers, right? So I picked this up and I made out of Mike Rowe, whatever the guy's name is. I can't remember his name now. But
thing.
It looks like it's an old retro... Got to open it that way, Fred.
Oh, it's that way, sorry.
No instructions, jeez.
I'm not good at opening things.
No, but look, a couple of beers in there. Beautiful, but isn't it gorgeous? I love it.
There you go,
men's
Tom.
Things there, facial scrubs, facial moisturisers.
Heaps of gifts.
We've got more mini
can we have
towers.
A look? Can you lift that one up, Grace?
That one's got that one's louder
Hang
than
on,
all
Grace.
The others.
I'll take that away for you.
And also you'll see if you turn it around, you've got an FM radio in there as well, and you can be 10 metres away. So you could actually have this by the pool. You could be on the other side of the pool. Don't electrocute yourself, because that wouldn't be a very Merry Christmas.
Lego is big at the moment.
And you know what's bigger than Lego? Duplo, because it's
Why
big.
Is that? What is that?
Well, it's just a bigger version of Lego.
Oh,
that's all
okay.
it is.
I've got some pictures there.
We better not wreck the box. But everyone loves Duplo, and it's really popular with the kids.
Okay.
It was another kiddie thing that we had here before.
And Where that's for that? One and a half up to 5 years old.
This is fantastic. This is called Shopkins.
Yep, there you go.
All right. You know when you're a kid, you want to get and you go through the aisles and you put things. I don't see any cigarettes here. Anyway, but you go up and down the aisles. Now, I hate going to shops, but kids this age, you know, 3 to 5 years old, they love it. Get a few years, kids, you'll be over it too.
What else have we got over here?
Oh, look. Smelly things.
Oh, there you go. There's some body wash for the ladies. So basically,
the guys might like
Kmart
too.
Has got heaps
oh,
of stuff.
Oh, Lord.
They've got perfumes, they've got shower gel, they've
Look
got
this.
Everything.
This
they've is something I picked up.
They've got Maritalades as well.
I picked that up for myself because I love entertaining at home. Cheese platter, salami, olives.
Whatever happened to plates? I'm sorry, but whatever happened to plates? Why do you have
they
to
broke.
Eat off a black of, block of wood? This is great. If you've seen 50 Shades, this is really good. So I'd wipe it off before you use it as the platter.
And what about this one? Now, this is like
We've
the toothbrush.
We've spoken about
set,
that. That's the toothbrush.
I love that.
This is what I love too. If you want to annoy as many people as you can when all the family comes around, this 100 water balloons in 60 seconds, and just throw them at your relatives.
Now, can we look at this one?
We can, because I was hoping you wouldn't pick that because I was just going to take it home. Drones. Drones are really, really in. This one does 360 maneuverability. If you put a camera on it, you can see your neighbours going naked, skinny dipping next door. Fantastic. How much is that one?
I think it's about $199.
Which is really good for a drone.
Yes, it is. It's quite
okay.
True. The makeup kit there as
oh,
well
the makeup,
for young
that
girls
Merry
or
Christmas,
ladies.
That's
Thank
for you.
There you go. I'm going to give that to Lauren, actually.
All right. You've got the drink container here, and if you want to put something in it, here you go, strawberry daiquiri.
That is awesome because you just mix your own
I've
alcohol
into it.
I've
made these before. You just put your rum in it, put in the freezer in it, and this is great. All right.
That is an awesome doll. It's nearly taller than us.
Do you know what's big? this year, Frozen. Anything to do with Frozen? She's a
Let it go.
So I don't know what's wrong with Elsa. I think she's been in the daiquiri because she's looking a bit weird in the face there. But the girls and some of the guys are going to love it. Now,
what's that drink holder thing you've got behind you?
This,
is that a glass?
Yeah, so this is all self-contained here. Mm. You'd put whatever drinks you want to in there, and then it's got like a little thingy bob where you can actually fill up or just lay underneath it and just open it up. Or you could, yes.
Look at
you
this.
You really put red wine
which
in here.
Which camera we got, Fletcher there?
Are the kids listening?
Look
red
at that,
wine
Fletcher.
Into this. Put the red wine into your water bombs and make sure you just get the people wearing white. Okay. Marvel Comics. Look at this. This is my favourite. I've left the best
of
last.
Oh, that is awesome. Hang on, I'll move that out the way. So
move the sex toy down there. Look at that. It's got three wheels and it goes, spins around, goes up, down, round, about. I love it.
It's awesome.
I would just put a little a container here so that when you're sitting by the pool, you could just go and get some beer and then it brings it back over to you.
The many talents of these gifts. Have we got anything left?
No, I think I've gone through everything.
We've done the whole
I?
35. Thank you to Kmart. Thank you to Natalie, of course. And thank you for bringing your little new dog to the show as well. Kmart are wonderful people. We helped them with the Kmart Wishing Tree.
Yep.
There's still a few more days for you guys to go to Kmart, put a gift under the tree, get a tag and give it to some of these kids that got nothing. It's wonderful, wonderful cause. And thank you very much for Kmart for giving us all these gifts. Now, can I just say, one lucky person's going to get an array of these gifts. It might be worth about $500. All you have to do is very simple. All you have to do is put the code word. The code word is on the screen right now. There it is. There it is. You can't see it, but it's there. It's Kmart. Kmart is the kit. It's up on the screen now. Kmart and the number. There it is. Thanks, Liam. 0439 929 929. I need your name and your address and we have your phone number because you've SMS'd it. The word has to be Kmart and we will pick, out of all the entries, I will pick one person who I believe deserves it. Now, to make it a little bit easier for me to pick, tell me why you think you deserve the gifts. Very brief, tell me why you deserve it, not because you think you should just get them. But thanks to Kmart, we're going to give those away just before Christmas. So if you get in now, you've watched the show tonight, please enter and we'll give you those gifts. Thank you very much to Kmart and we look forward to having your company next year and thanks for all the great things you do in the community. And thank you to Francis as well, Francis Higgins from the Maddington Kmart here in WA, the head office, who organised all of this as
Brilliant.
Well. You're a wonderful lady. Let's give her a big round of applause in the studio.
Yes.
To Francis, Patrick and all the team at Kmart Maddington, they do a wonderful job. That is it for the show today, folks. Thank you. Just before we go, I'm going to say thank you to everybody. Thank you to Nat for being such a wonderful lady to work with. She's a lot of fun. It's a pity we don't have her more on the show, but she works for the RSPCA and she's very busy doing great jobs. Can I say thank you to Charlton? Can I say thank you to Nesha? Thank you to Grace. Thank you to Kayla, one of our camera crew. Thanks to Jake, one of our new camera people and technical crew. I've said thank you. Let's have a look. Thank you to Charlton. I keep calling you Charlton. Fletcher, thank you very much. Always there to help us. Thank you to lovely Veronica. I'll walk over here. This is Fletcher. Hello. Oh, hello. Too much Fred is always enough. This is Veronica. Thank you for joining the show this year. This is the wonderful Rachel. You know, if in another world, in another place, we'd never be together. Thank you very much, Rachel. And thanks all the work you did with Mission Australia too. Wonderful job. Rocky, who looks after all our guests. He's over here. Thank you to Rocky for all the great jobs. There you go, Rocky. You're on. Thanks for everything that you do. Thank you to Lauren. Thank you to Louise, and thank you to Chris for bringing Nat in every week and taking her home, more importantly. Thank you to everybody. Thank you to Ben, who's in our control room. Thank you to Liam as well, who's our wonderful director. They want me to move the camera out of the way. We're going to go in there. Okay, let's go in. This is live TV. We can do this. I feel like we're Channel 9 here, doing these behind the scenes. There we go. Let's say thank you.
Hello.
Didn't like that back shot, but that's okay. Thank you to Liam, our director. Thank you to Ben, our sound guy. Thank you to Tanusha, a new sound person. Thank you to Brendan, one of our regular DAs here at the couch. And that's about it. Shall I wrap it up from here, Liam?
Sure.
We're going to wrap the show up from here. And oh, one very important person over here, Tony Miranda. Can't forget him. He's my brother. We never appear on TV together because there's not enough room.
Twins.
But thank you to Tony. He does a wonderful job. Thank you to Adrian, who's right in front of... can't see. Let's go back in there. Adrian, come on, let's go. Let's go back in there so that Fletcher can get a shot of Adrian.
Oh, God.
Okay, Tony, let's go back in here. Oh, there you go. Thank you to Adrian. He's over there. He does an amazing job putting the set together, putting the whole show together at times. And doing as he's told at other times. Thank you very much to everybody. Have I left anybody out that's not here today? Thank you to Demelza. Thank you to Brendan, who was part of the show. Thank you to Cameron Kippen. Thank you to Ted Bull. Thank you to Cameron Lynch. And I think I've got everybody. But thank you to everybody and Annie Kay, who's been part of the show. It's a huge show. It's such a pleasure to bring it to you every week. These people work incredibly hard to make the show happen. With all the technical issues we have, we still bring it to air. Thank you to Foxtel. 8 or 9 years we've been on Foxtel. They still make local television, and only you can only make local television with local people. So thank you very much to Foxtel.
Big thank
and,
you, Fred.
And a big thank you to me. And I'm pretty much pooped. And thank you to everybody. If I've forgotten you in this, I'm sorry, but thank you very much. We'll be back next year in some format with a new set, maybe. I won't promise you anything. But keep watching The Couch. Thecouch.com.au is our website. Thanks again to everybody. Merry Christmas. Happy New Year. We'll leave you with Carly Wilcox. So This Is Christmas, and I'll see you next year. Bye-bye.
This is Christmas, and what have you done? Another year over, a new one just begun. And so happy Christmas, we hope you have.
is me and Louise Anton Miller having a bit of fun behind the scenes of the Christmas show.
Time for lies.
Connect with The Couch online through Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, YouTube, or thecouch.com.au.